Preprints are becoming increasingly popular in many research fields. But what are preprints? Over the next few moments, I'm going to explain what preprints are, weigh up their pros and cons, and finally, outline how to responsibly cite preprints in your work. So let's start with a definition. A preprint is an early version of a research paper that has not undergone formal peer review and publication in a scientific journal. It's made available to the public through various online platforms, and they allow researchers to share their findings rapidly to the scientific community and the public. While preprints are relatively new in some fields, the history of preprints can be traced back to the early days of the internet. The first recognized preprint server was Archive, which is a preprint server for physicists launched in the early 90s. Over time, various other disciplines launched their own preprint servers. For example, within psychology, popular preprint servers include PsychArchive and Open Science Framework. Some publishers have also support their own servers, such as Research Square, which is supported by Springer Nature. Now, let's move to some of the advantages of preprints. The first major benefit with preprints is that they allow the rapid sharing of work. Formal peer review, in which expert peers evaluate the suitability of work for publication in journals, can take anywhere from a few months to a year or more. Research papers are typically peer-reviewed by around three other peers, sometimes more, sometimes less, and peer review is facilitated by an editor or editorial team, and peer reviewers provide feedback to the authors on the strengths and limitations of a research paper. Sometimes they also provide recommendations to the editor for the suitability of a paper for the journal. One example of limitation could be a mismatch between the research paper's conclusions and the methods that they used. Perhaps they were making claims about causality, but were not using the best methods to do this. Peer reviewers typically provide a recommendation to the editor, who then makes the decision based on this feedback. It's extremely rare for a paper to be accepted after its first submission. Usually, the editor will return the paper to the authors with a peer reviewer's recommendations on how the paper can be improved. The authors then address these issues and return an updated manuscript for the peer reviewers to evaluate again. Sometimes the peer reviewers and editor are satisfied with these changes. Other times, another round of revision is required. This process can take a long time, which means there's a big time lag between when the authors want to share their work to when this work can actually be published. Of course, at any stage of this process, the paper can be rejected, and the authors will need to try again at another journal. For me, my rejection record is 7 rejections, but that is an outlier. But in general, many papers are not accepted in the first journal they're submitted to. Within many scientific fields, such as psychology, this time lag has been the norm for decades. In addition, for some journals, it can be months between when a paper is accepted to when it is actually published online. With preprints, authors can share their work immediately. Not only does this mean that others can read their work straight away, but it also means that authors can get early feedback on their work from anyone. Typical peer review is only limited to a few people who may miss important areas for improvement. In my own work, there have been several papers that have been improved by others sending me feedback on my preprints. Another benefit of preprints is their accessibility. Many journal articles are paywalled, which means that unless you have a personal or institutional subscription, you can't read the paper. A preprint version of a paper can be accessed by anyone. Here's a quick tip. If you search for a paper on Google Scholar, it will often show you both the paywalled and preprint version of a paper, so you can easily access the preprint PDF. Another bonus of preprints is that you can see how they have been updated over time. It is easy to read a peer-reviewed article and think that this was the first version of the work, but what you're reading is the product of many iterations, both while the authors were writing the paper, but also during the peer review process. Most preprint servers have version control, which means you can look through all versions of a preprint and see how they changed over time. Most of my own preprints have about 3 versions due to updates I've made along the way. Preprints are cited in the same way as formally peer-reviewed papers. Most preprint servers provide an easy way to export a citation, or you can use Zotero to save the citation in PDF with one click. The latest version of the APA style manual provides examples of how to cite preprints. Now, onto some preprint limitations. The first limitation, which you may have already considered from what I've just been saying, is that preprints have not undergone formal peer review. Most preprint servers have a very basic review process in which someone vets papers to make sure they're scientific work and within the scope of the server topic. Some preprint servers, such as Open Science Framework, have a broad scope, whereas others, such as MedArchive, which only publishes human health research, have a more limited scope. This means that if you submit a paper on geology to MedArchive, for example, it won't be accepted unless it is somehow relevant to human health. All that to say, a paper that follows general scientific principles but done poorly is still likely to be accepted on a preprint server. And this is one of the trade-offs for rapid dissemination. However, one thing I really want to stress is that peer review is by no means a guarantee of research quality. As I mentioned before, only a few people are involved in the typical peer review process, and these people can make mistakes. Any scientific article should stand on its own merits, whether it's a published in a peer-reviewed journal or whether it's a preprint. So any article that you cite should be read carefully, whether it's peer-reviewed or a preprint. Another thing to consider is that most researchers care about their reputations and don't want to be known as somebody who submits lots of low-quality work to preprint servers. As I mentioned before, preprinting has been used in physics for decades, and this worry about researchers flooding preprint servers with low-quality work hasn't come to pass in general. But of course, this doesn't mean it can't happen, so it's important to read preprints carefully. Another concern I often hear is something along the lines of, won't people steal other people's ideas if they share their work before publication in a journal? Looking to the field of physics again, this hasn't come to pass. This is mainly because a preprint provides a time-stamped evidence of precedent. Authors can always point back to a preprint as evidence that they suggested an idea or found a particular result earlier. When it comes to searching for preprints, you can either do a direct search within a preprint server, much like you would within a specific journal, or you can use a database that covers many different preprint servers. Google Scholar indexes preprint servers along with Europe PMC. Some preprints that you will come across are older preprints that were originally posted a few years ago that are now published in peer-reviewed journals. Most preprint servers provide a link to a peer-reviewed version of a paper if it exists. If this is the case, the peer-reviewed version should be cited. Like journal articles, some preprints have additional supplementary materials. This might be data or additional information regarding the paper's methods. Preprint servers also include these materials or a link to where these materials can be located. To sum up, preprints are a fantastic tool for rapidly sharing and reading information without paywalls. However, just like traditionally peer-reviewed research, they should be read and cited with care.